Welcome back to ScottiesTech.info. I'm Scotty with my co-host Cletus. Right on. This video is about LED headlamps and which one is best. In my last video, I was talking about LED flashlights and how much I love them. But more than LED flashlights, I love LED headlamps. Mostly because they're hands-free. You can stick it on your forehead, and wherever you're looking, the light is shining. Bob's your uncle, right? They are very handy. The straps are always extremely adjustable. My cranium is approximately the size of Jupiter, and this one actually has, it's plenty big. So whether you're like, you know, a pea brain or like super brainiac size noggin, bowling ball head, they're always adjustable. So they're always very comfortable. And the only question left is, well, which one do you get? So let's take a look at a couple different ones, and I'll tell you which one is my favorite. So the absolute cheapest one is something like this, which is just an Energizer. And of course, he's got, like, you know, multiple different modes and everything, red light and... Yeah, this is, it's not bad. I mean, you just stick some AAA batteries in here, and these are very cheap. You can buy them pretty much anywhere. The only thing I don't like about these is that you see this lovely clear plastic. It's like they try to make it look like car headlights. And the problem is that this is the side that will actually be facing down towards your eyes because you wear it with the switch on top. So the problem is that when these LEDs are on, you get light that's actually kind of like refracted or reflected through the plastic here. And sometimes in some of them, the LED is actually so far forward that it is actually directly glaring like right down into your eyes. And that makes it kind of like sucky if you're, you know, outside at night and you're trying to do something. You're actually blinded by the light coming from the bottom of these silly headlamp, car headlamp things. So that's kind of the only thing I don't like about them. They're also usually not the brightest, but the big drawback is this silly plastic stuff they put here and how it glares into your eyes. So these are kind of like emergencies only, you know. Then we have something like this, which is, this is an older one. This is an Energizer, but you see here, this is the bottom, and it's nicely shielded so you don't get glare in your eyes. And it's also this big honking clunky thing. But it uses whatever kind of batteries, and again, it's got, like, you know, all the different light modes and the super mega bright light and all that stuff. Like I said, this one's a couple years old. It's not bad. It's kind of heavy and clunky, but this main LED is actually very, very bright, and you can go with something like this. You know, you have your basic cheapy one here, the slightly more expensive one. You know, it is a little clunky and kind of heavy, that's kind of its only drawback. So if you don't want to spend too much money, instead of the cheapy one, go for something like this. And yeah, that you'd be relatively happy. But my favorite is this guy, which is the Black Diamond Revolt. Now, this is the, I think this is like a 2015 or 2016 model year. He's got ungodly bright light. And you can adjust the intensity by pressing and holding and stuff and blah, blah, blah. This thing has like so many modes. It's like absurd. You can like double press and hold and press and like spin around in circles. And it'll do like a disco mode and all this kind of stuff. I just use it for this. And if I want it dim, I press and hold until it, you know, and then press it again, it turns off. I don't use it for anything fancy. It does have a battery charge indicator on the side. You can actually, lock it so it doesn't accidentally turn on, but this one basically you can put alkaline batteries, you can put like lithium non-rechargeable batteries in it, but it comes with three AAA rechargeable cells, and it's called the Revolt because it has a little port here, and to charge it all you have to do is stick your little USB cable in and plug it into your computer, your laptop, USB charger, whatever, and it charges him up. This guy is the Black Diamond Revolt. The Black Diamond makes very good headlamps. He is about, I think he's about 55 euros, $55 thereabouts. Again, a little bit expensive, certainly more expensive than this one. This one's super cheapy. This one's a little bit more expensive, and this guy is your kind of more top of the line one. As I was going to say, there is a standard version of this. There's also a slightly newer model of this Revolt. Not all of them come with the charging port and the rechargeable batteries. I would go for the rechargeable one because it's bright, it's lightweight, it's not too clunky, and it's extremely convenient to be able to use it. You're going to get about 4 or 5 hours of good intensity light out of it before it starts to dim, and it'll after about 4 or 5 hours, the level of the light starts to dim, kind of imperceptibly. So, if you use it for like 8 hours straight, the last several hours you're going to suddenly notice like, oh, what the heck? Like the light's not as bright as it used to be. So, in terms of actual light output, do not listen to a single word that anybody says, because this guy is the year-old model. The Black Diamond Revolt, and there's a 2017 model that's slightly smaller, and they claim, oh, this one's like, it's even more, it's like 8 gajillion lumens or something. Well, when I got this one about a year ago, he was claiming to be I think 130 lumens at max power if you're using alkaline batteries. If you're using the rechargeables, which is the benefit, you can recharge with a USB cable, then the light output's going to be lower. And in any case, the point is that the standard Black Diamond, the non-rechargeable one, they'll say, oh, it's 90 lumens. This one, they'll say it's 130. If you read reviews of these things, you will very quickly discover that the lumens, the light output rating that they give for these things is just complete and total bunk, because everyone wants the higher and higher number. So your best bet is to like watch some reviews and see what people say, because the marketing spiel with the super, ours is like 20 million lumens and it lasts for 30 hours, like, no, it lasts for a few hours. And I think this one they actually say lasts up to 300 hours. Yeah, it's gonna be like barely glowing at the end. So, yeah, so ignore the lumens. You can either go cheapy, you'll probably be blinded. You can go slightly more expensive with something like this. It's okay, but I wouldn't want to use it all the time. Something like this guy, he's very good. It's comfortable, it's light, and the most handy thing, as I said, is it's rechargeable. So like I can use it, working on whatever, an electrical panel or something, or doing something, underneath the car or whatever. And you got this thing and it's the light's shining exactly where you need it, and for like I say, a good 4 or 5 hours, you're fine. And then when you're done, you just take it back inside, and when you go to your computer and check your mail or whatever, you just plug the sucker in, and when you get up the next morning, it's fully charged. It's pretty handy. So, yeah, that's my favorite headlamp, the Black Diamond Revolt. So that's about it. For more techie tips, see ScottiesTech.info. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.